Hello guys, welcome back to TechDose, and in this video we will see the integer to Roman problem, which is from lead code number 12. It is an implementation based problem which is frequently asked in interviews, particularly in Amazon. So before looking at the problem statement, I would like to announce about the TechDose DSA live training program, where you will be guaranteed the understanding of concepts and it will help you prepare for your upcoming interviews in just 3 months, which will help you maximize your offer. If you want to know more about the course, then you can WhatsApp TechDose on this given number and you will get the details. Let us now look at the problem statement. This is a very straightforward problem in which you are given a decimal number which you need to convert to a Roman number representation. The Roman notations which are given are corresponding to 1, 5, 10, 50, 100, 500 and 1000, which are I, V, X, L, C, D, M. Okay, so this is mentioned in the problem. Now, any number can be represented in the format of the Roman number, but there is a catch to it. Now, let us understand, can we easily do it by the given notations? So, let us start representing from the number starting with 1. So, let's say you are representing a Roman notation for 1, and that will be just a single I. And for 2, it will be 2 I's, right? It will be 2 I's. For 3, it will be 3 I's. But what happens if you get a 4? For 4, it is not 3 I's, but it is an I followed by a V. When you write in this manner, that is, if you write an I on to the left side of V, then this means that to the value of V, which is 5, you are subtracting the left hand side value, which is 1, and this becomes 4. This is the usual meaning. Now, for 5, you simply write V. Right? And what happens for 6 again? For 6, you will see that you write V followed by an I. Right? Then for 7, you write V, I, I. For 8, you write V, I, and I. That is triple I. But for 9, you don't write V followed by 4 I's. But instead, you will write I followed by an X. The value of X is 10 in the notation. And writing an I to the left of it means that subtract value 1 from 10 and this becomes 9. So this is the usual meaning, okay? So you will see that even though these notations are given, you will require one less value from the actual notation. That should be in multiple of 10. So we will understand this. Let us first write it. For 5, you will need 4. And what will be the notation of 4? It will be IV, okay? And for 10, you will need 9. Now the notation of 9 will be I followed by X. So you will see that 5, if you want to represent 4, then you will have to convert this 5 to the lowest 10th multiple. So this will go to this I, right? Because the lowest 10th multiple of 5 is 1. And also the lowest 10th multiple of 10, which is lower than 10, is also 1. That is why you need an I before this X. Similarly, what we can do is, if you want to see the previous number to this, like let's just forget about this 10, okay? So what should be the previous number? It should be 40. It is not 49, right? Because we have already taken care of all the numbers in between 1 and 10. So definitely between 40 and 50, it will be taken care of. But what about 40? In order to do that, what is the lower multiple of 50? I mean the lower 10th multiple of 50, it should be 10. So this will be represented as XL. Now for 100, the previous one will be 90 because it is a multiple of 10. Now what is the lower 10th multiple of 100, which is less than 100? It is 10, right? So it should be written as XC. And similarly for this 500, the previous number, not just the previous number in ones, but you see it is in multiples of hundreds. It was in multiples of tens. That's why I took the previous number as 40. Now the initial ones were just multiple of ones. That's why the previous number of 5 was 4 and the previous number of 10 was 9. But then from 10 onwards, 50 and 100 were multiples of tens. So we took the previous number to be 40 and 90. But then starting with 500, you see that 100, 200, 300, 400 and 500 is coming. So the previous number can be taken to be 400, and this can be represented with a CD notation, and all the numbers in between 400 and 500 will be taken care starting from 1 to 100, right? And similarly, so what was the lower 10th multiple, like the lower 100th multiple of this 500? It was 100. So we used C before this D in order to represent 400. And similarly, the lower 100th multiple of this 1000, which is less than 1000, is again 100. So we can represent 900, which is the previous number, as CM, right? So we need all these notations in order to convert a decimal number to a Roman number. And I hope you got the reasoning why. Because in order to represent 4, I cannot write this I 4 times. Okay, this will be wrong. So in order to get the correct representation from whatever the question mentions, you have to derive all the other notations as well, right? So I hope you understood why do we need this. So this is the representation. This is the entire list which you will require: 1, 4, 5, 9, 10, 40, 50, 90, 100, 400, 500, 900, and 1000. And all these white numbers can be derived from the teal numbers, right? Okay, all these white numbers can be derived from the given notations. So I hope you understood step one. Now there is another step involved, which is about, if a decimal number is given, how do we know how to break it and represent it in the Roman notation? In order to understand that, first we have to understand, if a decimal number is given, how do we break in our usual decimal system notation, right? So we will break, always break in the multiples of as high number as possible. So this is the rule, okay? Now in the base 10 number system, like our decimal number system, whatever we use generally, if you are told to break 58,135 into parts, and let's say the notations allowed are 1, 10, 100, 1000 and 100,000, then how will you represent? There can be multiple ways to represent it. You can write it as 58,135 into 1. That means 1 is occurring 58,135 times. This is one notation. Another notation can be 5,813 multiplied by 10 plus 5 into 1. This is another notation. But you will see that out of all these notations, the most accurate will be, according to whatever notations are allowed, it will be 58 into 1000 plus 1 into 100 plus 3 into 10 plus 5 into 1. This will be the most accurate result which we want, right? And how did we arrive to this? How can we arrive to this? We can arrive to this by dividing this entire number, starting from the highest number possible and moving towards the lowest number possible, right? So let's see an example where I will be converting this into the most accurate result, and then you will be able to understand. So remember the rules. Always try dividing in multiples of the highest possible notation. If it's not possible with the current multiple, we will move to the next lower multiple, right? So let's try this out. So the highest multiple is 100,000. So now try dividing this 58,135 with 100,000. Can this divide it? No, it cannot divide it, right? So we will not take this. And since this is not able to divide it, because the number is lower than the divisor. The divisor D here is 100,000 and the number N is 58,135. So D is larger than N, so it will not be able to divide it. Now what we do is, if it's not possible with the current multiple, that is the current divisor, then we will decrease the divisor and we will go to the next lower multiple, right? So it is 1000. Now you check. If you divide this 58,135 with 1000, how many times will it take? So it will take 58 times, right? So you can write 58 into 1000. Now you try out with the reduced number. What is the reduced number? So since you have already taken out 58 into 1000, so the reduced number will be only 135. So will this 135 be divisible by 1000? No, it will not be divisible by 1000. So we will move to the lower number, which is 100. Now, is this 135 greater than 100? Yes. So it can divide it. And how it can divide it? It will be only one time. You divide 135 by 100, it will be only one time. So 1 into 100. And once you write it like this, you have to reduce this number and this will become 35. Right? Now the number is 35, again 35 is lower than 100, so we need to move to the Next lower multiple, which is 10, again this will take 3 times, so 3 into 10, and again this will be reduced to 5. Now 5 is lower than 10, so we move on to the lower number 1. 1 will divide this 5 in 5 times, so 5 into 1, and there is no lower number, so we will stop, and this will be the correct representation, right? So this will be the most accurate representation according to the given notation. Okay, the notation might change according to the question, but this is what we had assumed, and this is how you can do it. So this is the method by division, and this is the fastest method. But there is another method which you can do by using subtraction. Now how you can apply subtraction to this? So let's say the initial number was 58,135. Now this number is lower than this 100,000, so you will move on to the next number, which is 1000. Now 58,135 is greater than 1000, so one instance of 1000 can be included, and this can be reduced to 57,135. Now again this 57,135 is larger than this 1000, so again another instance of this can be taken, and so this can be reduced to 56,135. And you can keep on reducing this by subtraction in 58 times, and it will result to 135. But division, you can see that you can do it in just a single step, and this is much faster than your subtraction. So it is always preferable to solve this problem by division, but I will show you the subtraction method, which is very intuitive to understand. And once you understand the subtraction method, I think division is very easy to apply as well. Okay, so let's take an example of 2856 and try using our notation, that is our Roman notations, in order to convert this 2856 to a Roman number. So I have already explained you how to derive this entire set of Roman notations from the given set in the problem, right? That was the first step. Now this is the second step. Once you have derived it and you also have the decimal number, try moving from right to left. Okay, so try to follow this formula of first trying out with a larger number. So our pointer is here at M, which denotes 1000. Now you check 2856, is it greater than equals to 1000? Yes, it is. So you can write an M in our answer. So this is the Roman notation, right? The answer is a Roman notation. So you write one time M and you subtract 1000 value from it, and this will become 1856. Again, you check it in a loop. Is this 1856 greater than this 1000? Yes, it is. So you write another M and you reduce it to 856. Now, is this 856 greater than equals to 1000? No, it is not. So you will reduce this pointer to the next one, which is the CM. Now, CM is 900. Now you check if 856 is greater than equals to 900. No, it is not. So you again move it to D. Okay, so this is 500. Is this 856 greater than equals to 500? Yes, it is. So you can write a D here, and you can subtract 500 from this, and this will be 356. Is this 356 greater than equals to D? No. So you move on to the previous value, CD, which is having a value of 400. 356 is lower than 400, so you again move on to the previous value. C is 100. Now, is this 356 larger than 100? Yes, it is. So write a C here and subtract 100 value from this. Again, 256 is larger than 100, greater than equals to 100. So you write another C and reduce it to 156. And again, you need to do it one more time, and this will become 56, and you add another C. Now you see that 100 is actually greater than this 56. 56 is less than 100, right? So you move on to the previous value LC, which is 90. Again, 90 is greater, so you move on to the previous value, which is L. It is 50. Now 56 is greater than equals to 50, so you can add an L here, and you can reduce it by subtracting 50 from it, and this will become 6. Now 6 is less than 50, so you need to move to the previous value. Again, 40 is larger than 6, move to the previous value. Again, 10 is larger, move to the previous value. 9 is larger, move to the previous value. You see that 5 is actually less than this 6, right? So 6 is greater than equals to 5. So you can write a V here and reduce this 6, and you have to subtract it with 5, so this becomes 1. Okay, Now this 5 is actually larger than this 1. So you move on to the previous value. 4 is larger than 1. You move on to the previous value. And this is 1. So you can write an I here and reduce this 1. And this will become 1 minus 1, 0. As soon as you reach to 0, whatever notation you got is the Roman notation, right? So this is a subtraction process. Okay, and this is the simplest and the easiest one to understand. Once you are thorough with this, you can try out yourself with the division method. Let us now look at the code. In this code, you can see that the decimal number is sent and the notation, I have just hard coded the notation. You can also do that. But in the problem, you will see that M, D, C, L, X, V and I are given. But once you have solved this problem, I don't think you will fail to understand this, how to do this, right? So you can easily do it. You can hard code it anyway. And I have also saved the corresponding value. So you will see that this entire array is in decreasing order so that I will be parsing through it from left to right. You see that I have taken a for loop and the initial for loop is the position pointer which starts from the left hand side and keeps moving to the right from the higher value to the lower value. The inner while loop will actually do the subtraction. Okay, will actually do the subtraction as long as the number is greater than equals to the current value. Okay, the current notation value. And as soon as it decreases below the notation value, we will go on to the previous notation value. Right, as I had explained in the dry run. So this is the simple code. Again, if you are doing division, there will be no need to do a while loop here. And you can simply solve this by division in order of one time. You do not need to use a while loop. You can just use a division with the divisor n divided by d and you will get a number x. And these many times you have to repeat the given notation. And you can append the string by forming the Roman string these many times, like x times. So first I will recommend that you need to try this out with the subtraction method. And once you are good with this, you can try out the division method. I hope you were able to understand this video and you enjoyed it. If you want to get the best quality interview preparation, then do consider joining the TechDose live training program. If you like this video, then please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel in order to watch more of these programming videos. See you guys in the next video. Thank you.